The markets, how has it been favoring you? Because everybody believes that gone are the days of listening to Apala, this and that, people prefer to listen to hip hop, listening to these things. Who are your target market? How has the market has been favoring you?
Yeah, it's really going well for me compared to when I just started. Like in 2012, when I started doing Apala, it's not easy. It wasn't easy then, but thank God today it's looking good, you know. And me doing the kind of sound, you know, initially I do the R&B singing, you know, I'm a guitarist, you know.
Okay.
I sing R&B.
You started as a guitarist,
right? Yeah, okay. Started as a guitarist, you know, as an R&B singer. You know, compared to now, you know, people are appreciating what I'm doing more, you know, than then. If I'm called for a shit to come and perform, you know, I think the Nigerian music industry, they need my kind of sound, because If you call up to like 15 to 20 artists come and perform, I think they need my kind of sound, because you know, we have already, we have Timaya, we have Bonaboy, you know, people that are doing their own kind of sound. So my kind of sound, I think, is needed, because there's no how. You can call, you know, so many artists, you know, some of them do R&B, some of them do hip-hop, and I'm doing the African sound, put up on hip-hop, I think they need my sound. My sound is needed in the music industry.
How do you think they need your sound?
Yeah, sure.
Because this is a generation that we believe, in fact, in a little baby, we dance to hip-hop.
I strongly believe, even outside Nigeria, you know, I've gone to other countries, you know, where I see they appreciate my sound very much, you know. On my Instagram DMs, you know, I received so many DMs from popular artists out there, like J-Hoss, you know. So many artists that I can't count, that are not even Nigerian artists, you know. So, believe me, it's really going forward, man. Compared to
So what's the distance, sir?
Officially 5 years now. I started out in 20. My first song that brought me to the limelight was Modernize, 2015. Okay. Yeah, 2015. You know, we thank God, sir. That's what I was saying. Thank God, bring God all the way, not me. You know, because when I started this whole thing, it was so hard. But thank God, today, God has really softened everything.
Without to actually lead me to the next questions, yeah. What were the challenges that you believe these people that are on the same line of music as yours, what were the challenges they faced? And then you too, what are the challenges you faced at
session? I faced so much challenges, you know. Okay, let me start from 2015 when I dropped one song. On the day of the shooting, In the middle of that shooting, you know, I received a call from Musubi Shola himself. Because I caught some, you know, live bands, like the Talking African Percussionist, the Talking Drum Program, and others to come and do. The man that followed them to my location was, you know, was like, you know, junior sister to Musubi Shola. So I think he called Musubi Shola and sir. Then he come and call and the man was like, so he told his sister to my wife and to me. So I spoke to most of the children and said, you want Korean Apala? I'm only with me. I'm not going to show more about it. I'm not going to show more about it. He said, okay.
Wow.
But I'm not going to my same address. And about after like 15 minutes, I got the address on my WhatsApp and said, meet me now. So before I went there, you know, I have this fear again. Everybody on Pokemon Ball, you know, used to hear them saying, you know, back in those days, if you wanted to do Apala music, you have to be very, very strong, you have to be very, very healthy, you know. So, but with the church man, you know, I went there to see my solution. And thank God, later on, it wasn't challenges, I would say, because, you know, it's more like, you know, encouragement, you know, from the owner of Apala, Kuna. So Mr. Shola is just like my boss in the game, like my dad in the game. So the challenges are just, you know,
before we get to that challenges, when you don't mess with Mr. Shola, what transpired between the
two? Yeah, sure.
What did you do? What did he say?
Yeah,
to you
we had so many conversations. He said, okay, aside from this, parameter that I'm doing, no, aside from that. Apala hip hop that I'm doing, like can I really go into that deep Apala, like that we, you know, the Apala maybe thing. I said, I got that money, okay, you know, I said, okay, I should mention like, you know, 10 of his albums. So now mention like 10 albums, you know, what they should, do, do I know, and you know, he was so amazed that I mean, someone that's not even doing rap, but you know, doing Apala music, yeah, so said I should freestyle one of his, and yeah, I come for do tell you, you know, I wowed him that day, like, and tell someone you buy, you know, doing this kind of sound, you know. So that's what I said. So the challenges are just, you know, bringing something into the industry, you know, when you're being skeptical about, you know, what you're about to do, if it's going to work or not. So it's more like a 50-50 thing, you know. But thank God, today, it's no more a gamble. It's making sense. You know, I've mentioned, you know, so many cities that have gone to perform, you know, so many people that I got booking back-to-back, bookings back-to-back, you know, even outside Nigeria. Now, my plan is just to go to the UK to, you know, treat my song, my sound to them, you know, with their own artists out there. I've got a call from J-House, you know, UK artists, you know, share many of them like that. Okay. So I even dropped a cover today called Mushi to take cover of the song, big song in the UK, yeah, Rams back in here. Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm making moves.
I'm still going to come back to that challenge.
Yeah.
But I want to ask you this. You know, you are not Yoruba.
Yes, sir.
So what really inspires, as in, were you born into that?
Yeah.
So why did then? What really inspired that song in you? Like, okay, yeah, some kind of music I want.
Yeah, this is related to what I said the other time. I grew up in Nushi. You know, my school days, most of my friends are Yoruba. I speak more of Yoruba. But then my mom wasn't happy about the, you know, about the Yoruba language. Like me speaking Yoruba, because something that I'm supposed to be speaking my language, but I choose to speak Yoruba. But on that aspect of changing my style to Apala music, when I just sat down, you know, like I took a good look at the industry, like, you know, I see everybody is kind of sounding the same way. You know, we have so many, I can count like, I don't want to mention names, but you know, we can count like, you know, so many R&Bs, you know, artists, so many pop artists. So I choose to be, you know, distinct like from what people are doing now. So I treat that sound. Already I have that sound in my head. So the assignment that I had to do then was just, you know, fusing the English language and fusing to that Apala sound, you know, to make it more classic.
What do you inculcate that
Apala?
Okay, this is what I want to do. And then it's not that you have a
trait.
From member of your family.
From my teenage age, you know, I used to play can, and there's this man called Alaju Lukot in my area. You know, there's this old JVC Reddy. I might not be hearing what those people are saying, like what they were saying then, but what I can remember is then I was very, very, very young, you know. So that sound is, I don't know, sound weird to me, like to my hearing, like, what is this? So I started, yeah. You know, I started from mimicking that sound.
Okay,
like,
that sound.
You know, that sound, I really don't know what they were saying, but, you know, I knew this is something different, because then we used to listen to, you know, the Remedies, you know, the Azados, and more of the Two-Face P. So I think I've always had, you know, that strong belief on, you know, going to music. Awesome. And I play drums for my church. I play guitar for my church, so, you know, I shall mix the whole thing together, I shall just make it something different, you know. And then while I was growing up, you know, most of my friends were saying, though some of my friends were discouraging me then, like, you know, the Yoruba, but why you won't do it? You know, they say, why not? So many people than they do. But with the faith, determination, the belief that I had in me, then, you know, I have to just, you know, make it happen. You know, I dropped that song Modernize, you know. The reception was, you know, like huge, you know, compared to when I was doing the R&B, but thank God, you know, I pick up the whole thing, I started the whole journey, you know, I dropped my song Modernize and the comments were so huge. And that was how I kick off. So I just sent to Mr. Jack Music where I dropped my first song, the popular, not my first single, with my professor colleague. So I dropped Champion Shower. So Champion Shower was the song that brought me to the limelight.
Okay.
So here I am today.
So what has been the challenges that you faced?
Yeah,
you started 5 years ago.
Yeah, the challenges are, you know, not something serious, you know, as an upcoming artist, you know, you're trying to be out there and maybe your song, you have your CD with you and you're trying to, you know, put it to the ready for them, for people to listen to it. You need to look for resources, capital to blow the song out there, These are the challenges, Then when I'm performing, nobody's giving me kudos, nobody's encouraging me now, Like, just like they introduce you as an upcoming artist on stage, people are just staring at you like, what is he doing? For what this guy is seeing, Sometimes I will go home and, I felt so kind of like, shaking him. Is it going to work? These are just challenges. That's all.
But you can say now that the market is
growing. Sure. I'm getting paid for
it. So then what do you think, as a young guy that is doing this, what do you think you can put in into Akwala music?
Into Akwala music.
That will make it, that will revive it.
Well, the only thing I think I should do now, I'm always asking myself, even this is my period, he's always telling me, let's take Akwala music to international. The only thing I think I should do now is, putting, more of English, more vocabularies, phonetic language, to make it, some that will give me that wide acceptance, to other countries, for them to be able to, listen to me. They are feeling my song in other countries, but I think I need to put more English language, then a bit reduction of Yoruba, to make it more apparent. So I think I need more English language to take it international.
Can you do any collaborations with any of the hip hop guys?
Yeah, sure. I already had a song with J-Hoss, the UK artist, working on something with Sarkodie. Sarkodie, J-Hoss, I have a song with one Ghanaian artist, Kata Bada, the known artist in Ghana. So I'm working on international collabs because I've already done, my compilation of collabs in Nigeria, I think it's more than 50. Niniola, Faust, Bad Guy, Jimmy Jat, Don Jazzy, I can't count, Filo, Olamide, Rezi. Not this made my own song. They put me on their own song. So,
how many albums do you have to your credit now?
We have not dropped any album yet, but I have like 3 albums ready. Because I think dropping my album is not the problem now. I need to be much more out there. Before I can. But this year is November, I'm trying to drop my own EP called Akwala Wi-Fi. Which contains so many sounds on Akwala hip hop music, like the hip hop rap on Akwala, raga on Akwala, R&B on Akwala, so many genres on Akwala music.
So that is what you should expect.
Sure.
Alright, thank you. Okay.
So, can you explain your sounds? In fact,
words.
Like, what
does
it mean? Yeah.
Unique. Different, Akwala hip hop, distinct, special. That's what I'm calling that.
So, 5 years, then
you see yourself. I used to go to work, like I said, to see people. So, it's a gradual process. So, from Africa to international. So, MTV Base Award, Grammy Award. Believe me, I'm taking it to international, Akwala music to the world.
So what if, you said you're taking your music to international?
Yeah.
What if you're not accepted internationally? What are you going to do
about? That means I'm going to be accepted. That sound is going to be accepted, don't worry. For me, because my sound is different. What I'm doing, it's not what Jesus is doing. I'm different from Jesus, I'm different from Chris Brown, I'm different from, Beyonce, anybody you want to start counting. Yeah. So this is something different. So that's why I'm taking international. And for me to take this sound international, for me to travel out there to introduce my sound to them. So, believe me, next year, not even next year, before
we finish out.
Before I finish this year, believe me, man, my sound is already out now. For me to put this to you, I think I need to show you my DMs on Instagram to see the people,
followers.
Even yesterday, I was just being verified on Instagram.
So many people are verified.
Okay. Yeah, sure, yeah.
Do you have any other thing that transpired between you and Mr. Mushi?
No, nothing serious. Well,
so can you relate to can you tell us that is your mentor?
Yeah, sure, that's my mentor, Okay. But the only thing that is different between me and Mr. Mushi is me and Bina Palaipo. He's doing. So I'll boldly say I'm copying from him. Because if there's no Muslim missionary, then we are very good. So,
are you in any record label?
Yeah, no record label for now, but I'm on the management team.
Okay, God bless you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for your time. We appreciate you. What advice do you have for the younger ones that are coming? And then they are supposed to be like, you know, to have something.
What I always say to your community is just pray, because without God, you know, nothing is impossible. Like, nothing is going to be possible. So just be prayerful, you know, be hardworking, be determined. That's all. If you get into these things, you're fine to go.
All right, thank you so much.